me cry when you said goodbye. Ain't that a shame? My tears fell like rain. Ain't that a shame? You're the one to blame. You broke my heart when you said we'll part. Ain't that a shame? My tears fell like rain.
I love Fat Stomino. This is Ray. This video is a brief video on pancreatic cancer depression. And I say pancreatic cancer depression because although pancreatic cancer patients seldom will say it, there is a difference between pancreatic cancer and other cancers. And that's not to diminish any other cancers. That's why PC patients don't speak about it. But, you know, I've had people come up to me and say, hey, look, you're a 9-year survivor of pancreatic cancer. You've got it. You're free. You know, fly, baby. Enjoy your life. I had an uncle that was diagnosed with prostate cancer in 1970, and he's still alive, and you can't tell he even had cancer. Pancreatic cancer? Nah. It doesn't work like that. You know, prostate cancer has a 95% survival rate. Breast cancer, a killer, famous. Everybody knows the color of the ribbon, pink. Tell me the color of pancreatic cancer ribbon. You know, you don't know. Why? Because it's a 4% survival rate. Pancreatic cancer has a rhythm to it. And it is one hell of a ride. The surgery is massive, for one thing. It's called the Whipple. My surgeon called it the granddaddy of them all. 10.5 hours it took, and most of the time they spent scraping cancer off my veins because I was that close to stage 4, which would not have been a good thing. But you can survive. But the survival rate, you know, you can twist stats around and everything, but you can't deny that pancreatic cancer is the deadliest cancer that there is. And depression is a part of that because they fillet your insides to the point where they take out half of every organ you have, and then they sew you together and rearrange stuff and then send you home, and you have to adjust, and you keep praying that, man, if I hang on, I'll get back to normal, because you don't know. You have no clue about pancreatic cancer. Nobody does. You go in there. I didn't even know what the pancreas did. But you find out, and you also find out that it changes your chemistry emotionally. I was hospitalized about 4 different times. Serious depression. Oh, they loaded me up with all different kinds of antidepressants and everything. And I just read where they did this huge, massive study. Probably spent millions of dollars on this study and found out that the best remedy for depression is exercise. And that's something that I've known for years. It's hard when you're depressed to get out and exercise, but I'm talking about just walking. It makes a huge difference. And believe me, I have battled depression of all kinds, not just cancer. I've had other things in my life, and it's not like other cancers where you go, oh man, I got cancer, damn it. You know, it's not that kind of cancer. No, it's like clinical. It changes. You know, they cut out half your pancreas and stuff, and they change the flow of melatonin and all this different stuff. And so depression is so much different. And once you get cancer, everybody gets it. And it affects you emotionally. And if it affects you emotionally, it affects your loved ones, your caretakers. And I saw that happening to me. At a perfect marriage is in my eyes. But I saw it changing me. Saying things that I would never, ever, ever say to my wife. And I hated it. I hated it. I was forced to retire. I hated that. I was not ready to retire, but I couldn't. You know, I started out at 185 pounds at diagnosis, 9 years of clean scans, and I'm 119. And I'm eating like a horse, and, you know, I'm melting away. And that's depressing. And I found that if I can get out and just walk, pick up sticks in the yard, anything to sweat, to break a sweat, it clears my mind, because I still am in pain and I take pain medicine and I hate it. And I like to have a clear mind. I like to be able to think clearer, where you get all clouded up taking all this medication. And there's so much weight going on with the caretakers. And, you know, you worry about the relationship and you say things and you regret them. As soon as you say it, it's like, I'm sorry. It's not me. It isn't me. And it isn't. It's not me talking. It's what the cancer has done to me. Or maybe I've allowed the cancer to do. But this is for pancreatic cancer patients. The prostate cancer has a 95% survival rate. Breast cancer has an 85+ survival rate. You check around and then you see 4% for pancreatic cancer. So your cancer is different, and you just have to admit it, face it, and deal with it. You're not going to go back to who you used to be, unless you have a very rare, circumstances. Once you have the Whipple, your life is totally changed. But it can have value, and it can have worth, and you can survive it. I'm 9 years. It has not been an easy ride, but you can do it. But you've got to force yourself to just walk a half mile, turn around, come back, do it again the next day. Exercise is the answer for depression. And I'm with you. Keep fighting.